If you've ever used downtown parking kiosks, you might be interested in this following program. We're going to visit with Tiffany Brander, who's the Interim Director of the Missoula Parking Commission. In this show, Tiffany is going to tell us more about parking options, both in terms of how you pay and where you can park.
Brander, and I'm the Interim Parking Services Director at the Missoula Parking Commission. So our jurisdiction is set by City Council, and it hasn't really changed for quite some time, but essentially the boundaries are we go over to Madison, up to Railroad, kind of right over by the hospital. We sort of stop at their two-hour parking and then down towards the Higgins Bridge. If there were to be changes, it would be a large public process with public hearings and that sort of thing, so we wouldn't just expand our jurisdiction. And often I feel like a misconception is that if something is in our jurisdiction, we automatically go and, you know, slap down meters and start charging. And I think if you look in our current jurisdiction right now, you can see that really isn't the case. We have quite a few areas that are either 2-hour free parking or 30-minute free parking or just non-metered parking. And in those areas, you have the benefit of having 3 parking enforcement officers who can respond to the safety violations, such as, you know, yellow zones or parking in a crosswalk, that sort of a thing. So it's a real benefit to the jurisdiction in itself that you don't have to, you know, pay for your parking, but you do have those dedicated parking enforcement officers that are able to respond to safety issues like that, that the police department, you know, can dedicate time to maybe not necessarily more important tasks, but definitely a higher level of public safety issue. You have to download the app first, so it's just a quick download on the Google or Apple Store. There's no fee to download it, and then you just fill out a quick profile, and I think the whole process maybe takes a minute or two. It's generally pretty quick to get your first download, and then you just enter your license plate number and what zone you're going to be parking in, and it's really quick from there. Passport gives you the option to save your credit card information if you'd like to do so, so that way you can just move through the process quicker, but you can also enter a payment information with each time, and we accept Visa or MasterCard, and you can pay with the kiosk or on Passport. So across from the old train there is some metered parking there, and that's long-term parking, and historically it has been long-term parking, so it's just the addition of the kiosk, and that long-term parking is reserved for downtown residents and employees, and it allows them to park at a discounted rate at the long-term machine. So we offer discounted parking, like I said, for downtown residents and employees, and they're sporadically placed throughout our jurisdiction, so it's not just over by the MCAT studios, but throughout the jurisdiction. And if you're paying on Passport, that's zone 4062, but if you're just paying at a kiosk, those kiosks are labeled with stickers that say long-term parking only, as well as the signage for that block face is marked as such. And in order to get access to those meters, you just have to stop by our office to fill out an application, and you pick your own PIN code that you can remember. And then we just have that activated for a period of 6 months, and we renew, and it allows folks to park for $1 is for 5 hours, or $2, it gets you 10 hours. And so it's a vast discount. It's really great for folks who are coming downtown every day. They're here, you know, 8 to 5, and they're here during those busy hours. And so we had what we called 10-hour meters before. They had little yellow markings on them. So it's essentially the same idea, that we're just trying to support the downtown community and employees and allow them to park at a discounted rate. So we have our Central Park garage, we have our Park Place garage, and then we have the newest addition to the family, which is the Rome garage. All of those facilities offer your first hour for free, and then it's only $1 an hour thereafter. And we charge in our garages Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. until 6 p.m. So after that, on nights and weekends, it's free to park. They're a great option for folks who are wanting to stay a few hours but not necessarily have to pay for the escalating rate structure on the street. And there is mostly availability during the day in Central Park, but especially since Rome is new, we have a lot of availability in there for hourly parking, and we definitely hope people start to check that out a little more. So our escalating rate structure is essentially the fee structure for metered parking in the downtown area. So it starts off with $1 for 1 hour, $2 for 2 hours, and then it starts to escalate there all the way up to a full day is $18.50. And that's just for your average short-term parker, and that's to help the turnover of spaces in front of businesses and buildings that need that turnover. Your first meter violation is always $0. It's a forgiven ticket where we basically just say, hey, you've either not paid correctly, you haven't paid at all, we have no record of your payment in our system, and so you get that forgiven notice. And then after that, it escalates for $5 for your second, $10 for your third, $15 for your fourth, and then after that, it's $20 per ticket. And so that does reset every 6 months. So if you get one violation and then you don't have any more for another 6 months, then it resets and you would go back to that $0 forgiven notice. And that's just how our meter violations work. There's a different structure for other sorts of violations, such as safety violations. So safety violations are generally overlooked by most, but it's a really important function of what our parking enforcement officers do. So they're looking for safety violations that include folks parking in yellow zones or within a crosswalk. And if you're parked within a yellow zone or a crosswalk, you're generally going to be obstructing the view of a driver who won't be able to see a pedestrian, and that's a safety violation. So we write tickets for those. Additionally, our officers are enforcing accessible spaces and access aisles, and that fine is set by the state, so it's a $100 fine, so you definitely don't want to do that. And those are not really citations that will void, because it's very important that we're leaving those spaces available to those who have a permit and or a license plate that allows them to use those spaces. We are happy to issue temporary permits. So a lot of times folks will bring in their signed application from their doctor and say, I'm getting ready to send this into the state. And let's say it is just for a surgery or something like you mentioned, we can give them a temporary permit that's good for usually about 6 weeks while they're waiting for their either 6 month temporary or their permanent placard to come back from the state. So that is something that we do here within our jurisdiction to help those folks out. And while we're discussing parking with an accessible placard or hang tag, I think it's important to note that in our jurisdiction for metered parking and for accessible space parking within our metered areas, if you have a valid hang tag or license plate, you don't have to pay to park in an accessible space. And if there isn't an accessible space available, we also allow for folks to park in any metered space for up to 2 hours for free, as long as that hang tag or your license plate is showing. Yeah, so the Parking Commission has monthly lease spaces that we lease to folks throughout our jurisdiction. It starts with on-street lease spaces that are as low as $35 per month, and then it escalates depending on where you're going to be parking. So if you're in a gated facility in one of our garages, that's $85 a month. So it sort of just depends on, again, where you're going, how far away you'd like to park versus being right in front of your building, and then whether or not there's any availability. So in our Rome garage, we do have some individual lease spaces available, and those are $85 a month. And we do have a few sporadic places throughout the jurisdiction where we have on-street lease parking available. And folks can always check our website online or call into our office to see about availability. And if there isn't any availability in a particular area or areas, we do allow for a waiting list. So we get names and phone numbers and we'll contact people. So we are always a financial supporter of really great TDM causes. So transportation demand management causes. So we financially support the Zero Fare program through Mountain Line. Missoula in Motion is a wonderful program. I think any individual or employer should always check out Missoula in Motion. They have great benefits for folks who choose sustainable transportation. And we just offer a variety of donations to different folks.